People often compare it to swimming and gymnastics, and then you put that in the water. So you start off by doing swimming, and then you move into the synchronized swimming, which is like ballet and gymnastics in the water with music. In synchronized swimming, you need to be flexible, you need to be cardiovascular fit, you need to be strong, mainly in the core, but all body. So it's a combination of a lot of factors. It's not just one thing. So you need to be flexible in your shoulders. You need to be good at splits, right, left, and box split. There's many, many aspects in synchronized swimming that we train. The Olympic events are the duet and the team. The duet have two members, and the team have eight swimmers in the team. For the duet and team events, there's a technical program, which you have to perform a set of elements in order, and then you get marked on the elements as well as the routine. And then in the team, you also have the technical routine, and then you have a free team, which you can perform any movements, whatever you want. For synchronized swimmers, it's roughly 75% of their training is in the pool, and the other aspect is land-based. For example, GB synchronized swimming, they do roughly 42 hours a week with the majority in the pool. So they do 5 to 6 hour sessions, 8 hour days, depending on the day. I'll now have one day off, but that's for stretching and just doing rehabilitation work. And they'll focus on strength and conditioning. They'll focus on the core stability, which is a main focus in synchronized swimming, because there are a lot of injuries that come around the back area and the hip area. And then they'll be working on flexibility, so split work, on boxes, they'll be working on shoulder flexibility. And then there's also land drill, where they run through their routine on land with the music. Big question that synchronized swimmers get asked is, how long can you hold your breath for? This is not something that synchronized swimmers do. They don't just sit there and have a stopwatch and time, because you can't compare it to swimming an event in the water, because you're constantly moving. So you're going to be needing oxygen earlier than what you would if you were just sitting on the side timing. So what we do to train this is to do, for example, we do 25 meters butterfly and then 25 meters under. You do it in a minute and you do that 10 times. And that really improves the aerobic capacity, and it improves them to be able to hold their breath for longer and do more complex moves. So in the Olympic events, the duet and team, you're obviously swimming with other members. So you've got to constantly be able to check your patterns, and they'll do that by twisting their head to check if they're in line. And that's what they have to do that at all times. And then there's obviously the music, which is played underwater with an underwater speaker. So they're able to count to the music, which they can hear via the speaker. Something that makes an Olympic champion team event stand out would be incredibly complex lifts that had never been seen before, because it needs to capture the judges' eye and make them think, wow, that's impossible to do, so they'll mark them higher. And also it's a spectator sport, so it's more interesting for the spectators to see spectacular lifts, and more interesting.